Mike Sterling has asked us how to paint Tzeentch-themed Chaos Warrior armour. Now, to do this, what you need first of all is a really bright silver, so the best undercoat colour here is Lead Belcher Spray. But then, we'll need normal oil to give the armour some depth by shading it, and then we're going to start adding the Tzeentch magical effect to it. For this, we'll need Gulliman Blue Glaze and Lamium Medium, and if you want to, you can also use a little bit of Waywatcher Green as well. But after that, we'll need Stormhost Silver to highlight the armour. But you can see with my miniature, I've started out with my Lead Belcher Spray just here, and with that done, we're now ready to shade it using normal oil. I'm going to be applying this with my small layer brush, because what I want to do here is a recess shade, so I need lots of control over it. So use your palette for that to make sure you haven't overloaded your brush, and when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to paint this colour directly into any corner that you can find. So for example, on the shield here, what I do is follow that recess all the way around this star, just like this. Once you've finished applying that recess shade, you're then ready to add that magical colour to the armour. For this, what we need is Gulliman Blue Glaze and also Lamia Medium. And if you want to, you can also use some Waywatcher Green as well. Now, we need to start out with Gulliman Blue, and the reason why I'm going to be mixing this with Lamia Medium is because it's quite a strong colour, and I don't want it to be overwhelming on the armour. So what I'm going to do is just get a good little puddle of this on my palette there like that. That's a good amount there, and then I'm going to dilute it with a bit of the medium. So you don't want loads for this. You certainly don't want to go more than half of the colour with it, so I'm going to get a good brush full there, put it in and mix those together. And there we go. So then what you do is get a good amount of this loaded on your brush and pick one panel and paint this over one panel at a time. I'm going to go for the shield because it's a really large example. It's a really good one to go for here. What I'm going to do is just start painting this quickly over the panel like this, being as fast as I can to keep all the paint wet as I apply it across the one large area. Now, if you want to add a bit of variety to it, you can do using Waywatcher Green. And what you do is just get a small amount of this with a smaller brush. I'm using a medium layer here. And then just paint some of this on like this, so it just starts to mix into those colours around it, so you get a random pattern, which gives a very Tzeentchian theme to it. The colours are now completely dry on the armour, and you can see what a random effect they've given. Perfect for a Tzeentch theme. And once you're happy with it, what you need to do is highlight all the armour. For this, you need Stormhost Silver, and this is just an edge highlight following along all the sharpest edges of these details. With that highlight applied, this Tzeentch-themed Chaos Warrior's armour is complete. A nice silver with those hints of colour swirling within it. So Mike, I really hope that helps you out, and I hope you have a good time doing it as well, because mixing those colours on the miniature, well, it's really fun to do. So have fun, we'll see you again soon.